Etude Caprice by James Stephenson. Now, I knew James Stephenson when he was Jimmy Stephenson, and the two of us were about 11 years old at Interlochen, and we were both intermediate boys in Cabin 10 together. Jimmy was the best trumpet player I had ever met, and he has gone on to become one of the most celebrated and prolific living American composers today. So thank you so much, Jimmy, for writing this piece of music. It's really great. It's also really hard, and it brings up one important thing that I'd like to talk about, and that is finger technique in fast running passages and how I go about learning those sorts of things. So here are a couple of tricks that I use when I'm trying to learn difficult finger stuff. Okay, so the passage in question I'm going to use as an example is on the very first page of Etude Caprice, and it goes like this. So it's straight 16th notes, and it's very difficult to play because there are some awkward finger motions inside there, especially in the first measure. So there's some stuff that goes on in the throat tones, there's having to go like this with my right hand, there's some tough stuff in there. Now, what we tend to do as clarinet players, and as saxophone players, and as oboe players, and as flute players, and as bassoon players, and probably even trumpet players, is we play the passages that are easy faster. And we play the passages where our fingers tend to kind of glom up slower, and that results in a phrase that is not even. So if it's easy for you to play chromatic scales, would be easy. But when you have to play the second part, you see how completely uneven that is? So here's how you learn how to break those bad habits. It is changing the rhythm of those passages as you practice them. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to play a dotted rhythm, da 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 da, through the whole passage, and I'm not going to play it super fast. Here, this is what that sounds like. That a few times, paying attention to the ones that are not clean, and there's one very specific interval in the second measure that isn't. See if you can hear it. I did it better that time, so it wasn't so bad, but it's... That's a tough one for me. So I pay attention to those, and I may practice just those parts. I'm playing every other note longer, and my ear starts to hear those as important notes. So in essence, my ear is hearing. So you're training your ear as much as you are training your fingers. A lot of you may think that this has everything just to do with getting your fingers used to it, but it's actually more than that, because your ears hearing those notes is just as important as having your fingers play those notes, because your ear is what gauges if you're playing evenly or not. Your fingers, they're going to move however they move, but your ears and your brain are what make your fingers even or not even. Okay, so you do that a bunch of times, and we're talking like 10, 15 times until you've really, really got that pretty much covered at a slow tempo. Now you can go ahead and move the tempo up, but before you do that, I want you to do this other flipped up version of that, where instead of going da, 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 you go da, 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 da. Here's how that sounds. That a little bit more difficult, but what we're doing here is, of course, we're holding the notes that we didn't hold the first time. And so our ear is hearing those notes, and that would sound like. Okay, so this is all about just kind of breaking up the patterns that your fingers are used to playing so easily. Now, most people stop there, but we're not going to stop there because there's this other technique that I use so that once I've gotten that down and I want to start to kind of sand off the other rough edges, I pick a certain note in each beat to hold so my ear hears that note. So let me just sort of pick a random, let's say I'm going to hold the fifth of those 16th notes every beat. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I'm going to have my ear hear those. Here's what that sounds like. Okay? And I'm going to do that a couple times, and then I might pick a different random one. Let's pick the second one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2. It's hard to say. Okay? And you just sort of choose one of them randomly and you hold it. What that does is it forces your brain and your ears and your fingers to make sure that note is heard. This process only takes 10 or 15 minutes of time, and if you do it, I guarantee that you will play those passages more evenly, whether it's just a scale or whether it's something like this that's more complicated. Both slow and fast, you'll be able to hear the difference. Okay, so breaking those passages up is the key to even technique. So, Etude Caprice, James Stephenson, this is how you practice fast running passages with your fingers. Go practice. See you next time.